Students, welcome to 8th class biology. So we were discussing about the chapter microorganisms. Okay, so we already covered virus and bacteria. Last class we discussed about bacteria. I hope you already studied all those portions. So now we are going to study another type of microorganism, that is fungi or fungus. Okay, fungi, they are coming under kingdom fungi. All members of fungi or fungus, they are coming under kingdom fungi. Okay, then next we are going to look what are the characters of these fungi members or fungus. So first of all, these fungi or fungus, they are eukaryotic organisms. What is mean by eukaryote and prokaryote? Organisms are two types, either eukaryote or prokaryote. Prokaryote, for example, bacteria, they have no true nucleus and or they have no well-developed nucleus. But in case of eukaryote, they have well-developed nucleus or true nucleus. Okay, so fungi or fungus is a eukaryotic organism. And chlorophyll is not present in fungus. Chlorophyll is absent. Okay, chlorophyll is a green pigment which is found in chloroplast, especially in case of green plants. Inside plant cell, there is a cell organelle that is called chloroplast, which helps in photosynthesis. Inside this chloroplast, green pigment chlorophyll present. Because of that, green plants look like greenish color. But fungus, they do not have chlorophyll. Okay, then the fungi members or fungus, they grow in dark environment. Fungi grow in dark environment. And these members of fungi, kingdom fungi, they may be unicellular. That means they are made up of only one cell. Okay, only one cell. Example, yeast. Unicellular means only one cell. So yeast organism, they are single cell fungi members. But sometimes fungi members or fungus may be multicellular. That means they are made up of many cells. Example, penicillium. Or sometimes these fungi, they may appear like they may be macroscopic, like we can observe with our eyes. For example, mushroom is a fungus which is macroscopic. Okay, so these are about kingdom. The study about fungi is called mycology. Okay, all the members of fungus, they are coming under kingdom fungi. Okay, so these are the general characters of kingdom fungi. Next we are going to check unicellular structure of fungi, and we will study about unicellular structure of fungi, yeast, and another multicellular fungi and their cellular structure. Okay, so first of all, yeast is an example for unicellular fungus. Yeast is a unicellular fungus. And we are going to study what is the cell structure of this unicellular fungus, yeast. Okay, so first of all, the yeast. This fungus found freely in our environment. They are growing in sugar containing media. Okay, they grow very well in sugar containing media and they found in environment everywhere. And the yeast, it is single cell microorganism or single cell fungus, and they have cell wall. This is the structure of cellular structure of yeast. They have cell wall and they have cell membrane and nucleus present. So this is cell wall and cell membrane. And these are vacuoles and food granules present. So fungus, they have cell wall, they have cell membrane, and they have their cytoplasm. This cytoplasm, it is granular. That means inside the yeast cytoplasm, food granules are present. So cytoplasm is granular. Then vacuoles are present. Vacuoles present. These are vacuoles and these are food granules. Food granules present. And oil globules are present. Oil globules and glycogen. All these contents are present inside yeast cell. Okay. And this yeast, which helps in fermentation. Which helps in fermentation. Fermentation. I will rub this. Yeast which helps in fermentation. Using the enzyme zymase. Okay. So you know alcoholic fermentation. Alcoholic fermentation done with the help of yeast. This fungus yeast, okay, they produce the enzyme and which helps in production of alcohol. So the reproduction in yeast, reproduction, how they reproduce? They do reproduction by budding. So yeast reproduce by budding. Suppose this is yeast cell and they form bud, a small bud around their body, around their cell, and this bud detached from their yeast cell and it grow and become a complete yeast. Okay, that is called budding. So reproduction is budding. So cell wall present, cell membrane present, and this cytoplasm is granular. That means food granules present, vacuoles present, and also oil globules and glycogen also present in yeast cell. And yeast helps in fermentation using the enzyme zymase, and yeast reproduce by budding. Next we are going to study multicellular fungi mushroom. Before that we discussed about yeast, unicellular fungi, and we already covered all the important points about yeast. I forgot one point. Yeast perform anaerobic respiration. That means yeast, they do not need oxygen for respiration. Humans, we perform aerobic respiration. We need oxygen for respiration. But yeast, that fungus, they do not need oxygen for respiration. Next we are going to study multicellular fungi mushroom. So at what time you can see mushroom? Yes, definitely in the rainy season. Okay, if you see observe your surrounding area, you can see this mushroom at the roots of trees, in the wet soil you can observe mushroom. Okay, and this mushroom, they have two parts. One part of their mushroom under the soil and another part above the soil. The part of mushroom above the soil, it is called fruiting body. Okay, so this is fruiting body, and this fruiting body has an umbrella like structure. Umbrella like structure. Fruiting body. Okay, so these are the parts of fruiting body. They have cap and gills and stalk. And this part under the soil, and they forms network of hyphae under the soil. So look here, this is cap, and here below this cap you can see so many slits. These slits are called gills, and these gills, these structures, this slit like structure called gills, which bear spores. Okay. And this spore, when this spore germinates, they become another mushroom. Okay, so spore formation, it is a type of reproduction present in case of mushroom. So where these spores are formed? On these gills. Okay, when spore germinate, they become a mushroom. then this is the structure stone. Then coming to part of hyphae, this part is hyphae and this is unbranched hyphae found under the soil. You know, fungus body is made up of hyphae. So this is, these are hyphae, unbranched hyphae. If you enlarge this picture, if I take one part of hyphae, they are look like this. This is nucleus. So this is a larger picture of hyphae. Hyphae, their cell wall is made up of chitin and cellulose. Chitin and cellulose. So fungal body is called hyphae. What called? Hyphae. And these are network like structure. Okay. This hyphae. And hyphae cell wall is made up of chitin and cellulose. And this this hyphae again branch and form a network like structure that is called mycelium. Okay, so what is the difference between mycelium and hyphae? Fungal body is called hyphae, and this hyphae again branches and form a complex structure that is called mycelium. Okay. So these are about multicellular fungi mushroom, and mushroom, they perform reproduction by fragmentation and by spore formation, spore germination. So these spores, where these spores are present? Here gills. Okay, and these spores liberated and this spore germinate into a complete mushroom. And fragmentation means, if one piece of mushroom cut off and they form again new mushrooms. Then we are going to study different types of fungus. Fungus may be saprophytes. Fungus may be saprophytes. What is meant by saprophytes? The organism which take nutrients from dead plants or dead animals, those organisms are called saprophytes. So fungus may be saprophytes. Example, rhizopus is a saprophytic fungus. So what is saprophyte? The fungus which take nutrients from dead plants or animals. Okay. Then another example, another type of fungus, that is parasitic fungus. So fungus or fungi may be parasites. They may be parasites. What is parasite? These are the organism, they take nutrients from a living organism. Okay. So that is the difference between saprophyte and parasite. Example for parasite, Puccinia. Puccinia is another example for parasitic fungus. Then third type of fungus, that is symbionts. Symbionts means fungus make mutual interaction with another organisms. They do not cause harmful, they do not cause any problems to other organism, but they live like a in the mutual interaction. Okay, that is called symbiont. For example, mycorrhiza, example for a fungus, which is a symbiont. What is mycorrhiza? The fungus which grow on the roots of plants. The fungus which grow on the roots of plants, like symbionts. Okay, the fungus give nutrients to the plants. Instead, this plant which give protection for this fungus, and both are helping each other. So that type of relation is called symbionts. Example, mycorrhiza. Okay, so these are different types of fungus. Fungus may be saprophytes, fungus may be parasites, or fungus may be symbionts. Okay, so we clear the portion fungi.